Okay, so where should we start? Let's start with the first comment. Let's start with the first one. The young man said, now this one. I don't give a fuck about that YouTube. That shit on my face. So this was oh snap. Hey bro. I mean, oh no, I don't even care about that. That was a good one. He was cool. I was like, whatever, dude. Homie Matt Bowen said I was misinformed by Elvis. That was hella mad that I said Elvis stole music from black people. Why? Where were you mad? You'd have thought that nigga was his father. You'd have thought I just bashed you. You'd have thought I just bashed white Jesus. You don't know who I was talking shit about. God damn, you'd have thought I said Elvis was the devil. God damn. Look at this. He said the definition of racism. Let's look up the definition of racism. Hold on. Let's look it up. Let's look it up. 'Cause I want to be sure. I want to be sure that he actually gave me the right. You know what I'm saying? Because he said I don't do information. He said I don't give out. I don't. I was had the wrong information. You know what I'm saying? Okay, so this is the definition of racist, right? This is the definition: prejudice or against or antagonistic towards a person or people on the basis of their membership in a particular race or ethnic group, typically one that is a minority or marginalized. We are investigating companies about racist abuse. I never said anything about him being white. I said he stole from black people. I never said anything about him being. I really didn't say anything. With all I said, you said I talk trash about him as a person. If you just said I talk trash about him as a person, I would have taken that. But at no point did I say anything about him about because he was white. I didn't say because he was white, he couldn't make music. I didn't say because he was white, he was unable to perform. I said he stole music from black people. We're gonna watch this fucking documentary. Right? We're gonna watch this fucking documentary. This one right here, Elvis the Searcher. We're gonna watch the first episode today, and I'm gonna watch the second episode tomorrow because I got shit to do tonight. Okay, the next one. That's racist as an adjective. Racist as a noun, a person who is prejudiced against or antagonistic towards people based on their basis of a member based. Oh shit, I fucked it up. A person who is prejudiced against or antagonistic towards people on the basis of their membership in a particular racial or ethnic group, typically one that is a minority or marginalized. He's a white man that could dance with great hair. At no point is he marginalized nor minority. He's a talented white person. Yeah, back in the 80s, he may have been marginalized. He may have been a small minority, but now we got Justin Timberlake. There's plenty of him. So at what point does this correct? CSK, CSK. Let's look at your shit, SK. What you be posting? You be posting shit? No, you just be out here talking shit. Damn, son, you just out here posting shit. That's crazy. Thank you for watching though. Mike Dennison, people who say Elvis was racist are racist. When did I say he was racist? Maybe I need to watch the video again. Did I say he was racist? Who is this? Austin, but oh, Tom Hanks is in it. Ooh, wow. That's cap. Elvis did nothing but steal from black people. When did I say he was racist? I'm gonna find out. Okay, that nigga, he looks like he gets bitches. The actor, that dude, he looks like he does look like Elvis to me. Like, if you go from him to him, like, no cap, they look really, really you too? Like, they look oddly similar. Like, I'll give them that. They picked a great Elvis. You are the villain, my nigga. This better not be ass, too. The movie, it does not look ass. It does actually look good. No cap. Are you born with destiny? Why does he have a flash thing? You think he's the Flash? I like it. Give him a warm hayride welcome. Mr. Elvis Presley. I'm gonna fuck your bitch, you whack motherfucker. That superhero. Kind of crazy they did that. They have to zoom in on his dick though. That's kind of crazy. Is this Forrest Gump in the future? This movie does look like it's gonna be good though. I wish to
promote you, Mr. Presley.
I'm ready. Ready to fly.
I'm still trying to figure out what I said. Still trying to find when I said he was racist. Ain't nobody put a timestamp in the comments. If I say he was racist that bad, ain't nobody say nothing. Ain't nobody put a timestamp in that. Some people want to put me in jail. Elvis Presley wants to be Michael Jackson so bad. I made a joke about him being Michael Jackson.
Damn, well's moving.
They might put me in jail for walking across the street, but you're a famous white boy.
It is God-given because it was given to black people and he stole it. Let me stop. Then I literally say, all right, I'm going to relax. One, I was never going to relax. It was all jokes. And wearing the same shirt, too. Hey, shout out to washing machines. But still, I'm still waiting on when I said he was racist. Let me stop. At least he learned it in a black church. If he'd have learned it, like, if he'd have stole it from the hood, from the ancestors, we'd have had to box. But at least he learned it in church. Shouting him out for learning it in church.
Martin Luther King has been shot to death in Memphis.
That's all right for you.
Tragedy, but it has nothing to do with us.
It has everything to do with us.
First of all, he does look like he wears makeup. You can't, if you're going to tell me he doesn't look like he wears makeup, he looks like he wears makeup right there.
Everything to do with us.
It has nothing to do with us.
It has everything to do with us.
It has everything to do with us. I don't know why I did that shit, I'm sorry. Yeah, 5 shots of Botox right now. Yeah, hella makeup. Y'all think them male dancers male singers back in the late 80s, late 90s, when they was wearing makeup, do you think they sweat that makeup off? Huh? They wore makeup on stage. Okay.
Reverend once told me, when things are too dangerous to say, sing.
Hold on. You gonna tell me he's not wearing makeup? Sing. At least the person acting as him is definitely wearing makeup. Hold on, Elvis might not be the criminal that I think he is, because he's given a lot of shout outs to a lot of ancestors. Like, he's given all these niggas said I was racist, but didn't. Clearly, you didn't watch the whole fucking video, because I literally say, and there's a whole point when I say he's not the criminal. Hold on, Elvis might not be the criminal that I think he is, because he looks like he's given a lot of shout outs to a lot of ancestors. Like, he's given this story is saying, I admit that I stole from black people. And I apologize. This is what this movie is giving. Okay, this movie is giving. Second half, I kind of went off the rails. But that's what it's giving right now. Second half of it, I kind of went off the rails. But
I'm on before the shoot, and nobody's gonna remember me.
I ain't gonna lie. One thing you can't say, that boy is clean. Them outfits cleaner than a bitch, boy.
Need to get back to who I
was. What up, Slash? He looks amazing. Like, we cannot talk shit. He looks amazing. Amazing.
This can all be over in a flash.
We are the same, you and I. We are two odd, lonely children reaching for eternity.
When did I say Elvis was racist? Unless I said it in these last 20 seconds, 10 seconds.
I'd watch it on stream for free. I think I'm watching a movie made by a nigga that stole? Hell no. Fuck out my face, bitch.
And even then, even when I said he stole from black people, at no point did I say Elvis didn't fuck with black people. I said he took his sound from black people, which he did. He literally took his sound from black people. He was heavily influenced by African-American artists. It looks amazing. The movie Deadass looks amazing, though. It looks amazing. Like, I will watch it because it looks gorgeous. So at no point did I ever say Elvis was racist. At no point did I ever say Elvis was racist. Now, this, a shout out to Mojo Media.
Let's see what you're talking about, Mojo. Mojo Rawley. What you got, Mojo? Oh, you're an Elvis person. Oh, okay. Well, now it just fucking makes sense. Oh, he has the Elvis interview? Okay, that's kind of fire. Hold on. Okay, it's understandable, folks. A little, blah, blah, blah. He was always heavy influence, blah, blah. Epic series, blah, blah. Nobody can sing like the kind of music like colored people. Let's face it, I can't sing like Fats Domino can. I know that, but I always like that kind of music. Okay, see, again, he gave me evidence that Elvis just said he fucks with black people heavy. At no point, this is crazy. I really it does look like he wore makeup though, but it makes sense that kind of the dude's trying to be him. Again. You gonna talk about it's the good worst reaction, Shelby, but you still watched it. That's tough. And thanks for the comment. But again, when did I say Elvis was racist? Somebody provide me evidence. Put timestamps. I need something because I never said nothing like that. Now we're about to watch this motherfucking documentary because I actually am intrigued because it looks like I'm a big fan of history. I'm lazy though, so I don't do a lot of research. But I'm a big fan of history and I'm a sucker for a good story. So we're gonna watch this documentary. Shout out to Tom Petty. Shout out to Tim Zimmy. We're gonna get lit with it. And I'm gonna give my commentary. Damn, bitch, I was talking. I'm gonna give my commentary as I usually do. This is probably gonna get heavily cut up because I'm not gonna post an hour and fucking 45 minute video. I got better shit to do with my day, but I'm probably gonna cut it up for today, tonight. It's probably gonna be the last thing I edit tonight. Probably gonna be the last thing I edit tonight before I go to Schlizzy for the second channel. HBO, you better not take my shit down either. What just happened? You good? Okay. You better not take my shit down either. Let's go. And y'all, and the same niggas that was in my comment section for the first video, y'all better be back in there saying, oh, I apologize, you dumb bitch. The searcher. I don't even know what that means. Oak Farm Road. Okay, I'm not gonna cap. I'm definitely gonna skip through some of this if it can speed so long. Shout out to Tom Zimmy. Who's that noise? Is that young Elvis on the... I have one of those bikes back in the day. That's a garbage. God damn, that camera's got a fucking photo. Okay. Oh, that smells fire. NBC. In living color, you guess. Looking for trouble? Ooh. You came to the right place. Yeah, that's the face that got the bitches wet. I ain't gonna cap. I can see it. That's the face that got the bitches wet right there. What are you saying? Yeah, that's the face that got the bitches. You can't tell me Elvis ain't had bitches. Yeah, I think he was married too, wasn't he? He wasn't married? Oh, I thought he was married. That's a crazy bar. I was born.
He was married.
He was married?
Priscilla Presley, 1967 to 1973.
Didn't he die in 73? Or they got divorced? When did he die?
She died in 73.
Oh, she died in 73. That makes more sense, actually.
He died in 77.
Okay, that makes more sense. Oh, that's cute.
No cap.
Huh?
Ugly though, no cap.
I end on that note. See, you're not gonna disrespect that man's wife on my shit, bro. You're not gonna disrespect that man on my shit. You nothing to deserve that. Hold on. Is that him multiple times in the background?
It was intense. 68 special. It was either the beginning or the end of his career.
This crowd did not look into it, and I'm feeling hella disrespected because he was definitely fucking it up on that guitar.
Mistake of writing off a great artist by all the clatter.
I'm trying to figure out why this shit's so low. I got the volume turned down.
What he did that was so beautiful.
Okay, this shit was so fucking loud. I'm sorry.
That great, great music.
I'm gonna turn it down a little bit. Okay, just so I can be over it, just in case YouTube tries to fuck me. Bro, Elvis can dress, though. I cannot count. That nigga can dress. I thought it was pretty. I know what I need to do to celebrate all this. You know what I'm saying? We gotta get the suit jacket. Well, it's fucking my brain screen. I respect. That nigga was doing these full dances, this thick ass jacket. Oh, this nigga is really amazing. This nigga is amazing. He was doing these full ass dances and thick ass leather suit jackets. Is this all the glitter from her fucking dress on my shit? This nigga's going to the army? We go crazy. Elvis Presley. Wrong way. The Searcher. You know it's crazy that Forrest Gump really took that, he stole that move from him. That's funny as hell. Oh my god, was this filmed with my left toe? Oh, it is the early 60s, so actually it's pretty great quality. How about now? We're about right there. I'm trying to make sure I don't have it too fucking loud, but I don't want it to be too low.
When I look at photos of Elvis when they were young.
Oh yeah, he look like, that's a baby, that's a nigga that get bitches right there. That's the baby version of a nigga that get bitches.
I see.
Mama kind of crazy.
Looks angry.
Elvis was born in a
it'd be more to Justin Timberlake than Elvis.
Poorest of the poor. His twin.
I don't appreciate how they said the poorest of the poor live in those houses, and they showed a family of black people. That was kind of fucked.
Brother did not.
R.I.P. Baby Parsley. Didn't make it through birth. R.I.P. to homie. He ain't deserved that. He was a baby. He ain't deserved that.
When Elvis was 3 years old in 1938, his father was sentenced to 3 years in prison for forging a check.
3 years for forgery? Forging a check got you 3 years back in the 60s? Yeah, he was white too. That's crazy. Oh, he was poor. He was poor and white. Yeah. I'm sorry. I forgot. I'm sorry.
In the 3 years, he only spends 6 months in prison.
Okay, that's good. My jacket up. I'm sorry.
This was the end of the depression.
No shit, he's a felon. Give him 3 years in prison for forgery. Oh no, his wife said, never mind. I was gonna ask a question.
Ready here.
Like, I'm not even gonna cap. With all this lighting on me right now, I'm kinda hot in this jacket. But this nigga is wearing a full leather bodysuit. Like he's a pussycat doll. No disrespect to him. And he's performing his ass off. You're smoking crack cocaine if you're thinking I'm doing that. I wouldn't wear a full leather bodysuit to my goddamn mailbox. You think I'm going to wear a full body leather bodysuit on stage? You're out your goddamn mind. Oh, so this is the person that directed the special that we saw at the beginning. Okay.
Flabbergasted.
He just talked her out of her draws.
Elvis was a guy who...
Was that a tornado? That is a tornado. Oh nah, the Midwest people tripping. Oh, I got snacks. You know what I'm saying? Just in case. You know what I'm saying? Fucking snacks and shit.
Right into a wall and he bounced off and fell on the floor.
Divine providence. The loss of life, the destruction of property. It was...
Why'd she nibble on that bread like that?
It wasn't like you'd be going there and sitting back and crossing your legs and relaxing. You know, you get very involved and very energetic. And it's as much a feeling as it is hearing.
I've always...
Southern churches go crazy when it comes to religion. So what I'm hearing is all rock and roll is based off of church religion. Got it. I'm sorry, Southern church religion. I don't know if you can say black church. Southern hymns, that's what we're going to go with. You know, I don't want y'all to be saying, oh my God, he's racist again. Southern hymns is what we're going to say it's based off of. Rock and roll
is a subcategory of Southern hymns. Write that down.
Experience.
And a cigarette.
Elvis was like Huck Finn exploring.
It's a beautiful picture, though.
Night he would...
Gladys from that hymn.
Whoever did that, the King of Clubs, that's clever as hell.
A time where the country was into racism and segregation, and here was a young kid.
At the time, now?
Or had records. Or had a...
They didn't have to do sis like that. Like, they really didn't have to show his sis looking like that.
Radio.
Damn, we ain't gonna talk about my nigga teeth? What the hell? That's a nice bike. Fuck it up. Ooh, fuck it up.
Moving there after the war.
I thought, okay, so listen, the camera quality was so bad back then.
The power of that river.
Listen, I was really about to say something crazy.
Memphis is a very diverse city.
Asian people, snap. Look at the Asian homies, okay.
But a very diverse city, so you had a lot.
This makes them look like they have on blackface. This isn't... This looks very... It's black people. That's what threw me off. They're actual black people. But the way the shadows is hitting their face, it looks like blackface. It all looks like blackface. And I know it's not, but it's crazy.
A lot of people moving there after the war.
Except for that man, he was white.
Memphis developed a very vibrant entertainment...
I've never even heard of that. Ethnomusicology? Yeah, that's a niche group right there. We're gonna have to look that into that. Words are hard right now.
Part of the early New Deal housing program. It was affordable, but it was bigger than anything they were used to.
Elvis was alive during the Depression. No, that makes sense, actually.
To buy a record player.
Aww.
And they gave him that same sort of independence to go out in the city and be exposed to other musics.
You're seeing that every time you go there.
Beale Street was the black man's haven. When he come here, everything lit up. Lit up like a slot machine. Everything was fired up. Beale Street was the place.
Big shout out to Beale Street coming through, showing others the way. Beale Street making waves through black culture all through their years.
Looking at that, you would see how powerful it would be connecting to an audience.
Oh, stop your train, darling.
You know, like, back in the day, they used to perform in full suits, be sweating down in the middle of the club. And they perform every, and they wasn't using records to play, like, whole music. No, they was singing every song. They knew every lyric in a full suit and tie. Yeah, I should kind of pick in mind. You think Beyonce doing that? Absolutely not. Rihanna ain't doing that. Rihanna don't even make music no more. Mariah Carey ain't doing that. Rihanna's done with music. I don't know what to tell y'all. Rihanna's never making music again. It's a rap. It's, oh shit. That doesn't matter. It's a rap. Rihanna's never making music again, okay? Anybody looking for a Rihanna album, go ahead and cancel it. Unless her and, who's it, ASAP? That's her boyfriend? Unless her and ASAP break up, which was gonna, I'm telling you, they break up, the album that they those two individually drop, it's gonna be immaculate. But ain't nobody performing like this, bro. Back in the day, they was actually cooking. It was in their performance bag.
Elvis, he would park his truck in the alley behind the club, and he used to come around.
This must be when he turned 16. Okay, yeah, he's gotta be like 16, 18 at this point for him to be parking trucks and shit.
Down to the back of this place, and he would watch me play the old upright piano. When you see him stand up, he'd be doing his legs when he'd be playing with the guitar. All this came from back in those days when we used to do it.
One thing you can't say, that boy Elvis, he was a student of the music, though. That nigga, he was willing to learn everything.
And say, Jerry, look at that walk. I'm gonna use that.
Look
walk.
At that fucking shirt. Looking that shirt was beautiful.
Preacher, you know, fronting the choir in church. So whether you're James Brown or Elvis or anyone out there, your position basically is always proto-religious, you know?
So Justin Timberlake was the front man for NSYNC. Therefore, he was based off of a black preacher fronting for the black church. Boom. At the end of the day, all I'm seeing is it all comes from Black Church.
Those are just flat. Elf. Only thing ever failed.
They had a one of the greatest musicians of all time failed music class. Actually, that sounds about right. Actually,
it was amazing how popular I became in school after that.
Hey, Elvis. Oh my God, you're so cute.
Possibilities for art.
The Prison Air. Shout out to the Prison Airs.
What happened? The genius of Memphis at that time.
I fucked up and accidentally hit a button. Wikipedia did not mean to. How long is this? Okay. We're going to watch it until it gets to about the halfway point of this episode. Because so this way we can have more to do tomorrow. And I'm not tired out of my ass. And actually, I'm not fucking, again, tired out of my ass. And I already have a video going up for the second channel today. So I can just edit this half. And then boom, I can put that up. So boom. I hit the wrong button.
Was a convergence of forces. The emergence of radio. DJs and
I gotta make a thumbnail. Shit.
And then you add to that concoction the genius.
I ain't figure out my thumbnail.
Like Sam Phillips.
There wasn't much in the way of.
That's my thumbnail, William.
Black music recording. But
Elvis was looking for Sam Phillips.
I had seen him go by in his Crown Electric truck a number of different.
So is this who Tom Hanks plays in the movie? I'm asking again. I'm trying to figure out what's going on.
He had this beautiful voice, high voice, singing slow love songs, ballads.
And he sang.
I don't know when he hear that shit, man. Put some bass in your voice. I need some ragtime. You feel me? I don't want to hear Elvis hum music. Anybody trying to hear him Beach Boys his way into my heart, nigga? I want to hear some Ella Fitzgerald, James Brown. Say it loud, Elvis. God damn it.
Ink spots.
Getting tired and we stopped and had a Coke or something.
Elvis was just.
Wait, did they say they were doing Coke? Like the drug or the drink? You gotta establish these things because back in the day niggas was wildin'. So is he talking about the drug or the drink?
But out of the ordinary, or we may as well forget it.
Things aren't going well. Elvis is nervous.
We've been there 2-3 hours and starting to get late and we're getting tired and we stopped and had a Coke or something.
Elvis was just about a year out of high school, 19 years old.
That was the look that got the panties wet. You saw it? Y'all saw it? Y'all might have missed it. I might have missed it. Y'all might have missed it. Look. Look at his face. He's on a smile. When he smiled, you knew he got the panties wet. When he smiled, you knew he got the panties wet.
Memphis, Tennessee, and it's Friday night. Tomorrow's
WHBQ.
Growing up in Kentucky, he has got this entirely original take on the bluegrass, and it transforms into what would later be called rock and roll.
Tied on the bus, gonna let me blue.
Fine, man. Well, that's different. That's a pop song now, Nellie.
There's no one that creates music.
Got lucky. No, he didn't get lucky. He worked hard and he created.
Hey, that boy Elvis looks like he earned every second of his shot, boy. That boy was hustling hard, like one of the ancestors.
The music with great musicians.
More I did, the more they went.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? A little wiggly diggly. Grand Ole Opry House? Really?
Which was massive. I mean, you don't just get on the Grand Ole Opry.
The
Opry, you have to be a member. Being the Opry was.
I was really gonna fuck about what they want. It's what I want. I'm the musician. You came here for me. You know what it is.
It's very.
We were not faint-hearted.
Facts.
We certainly didn't know
We knew in time that something this great could not be kept under a bushel.
Oh God, we don't care if they don't cheer. We make fire music around here. Bars. Screenshot to show 7:30 to 10:30 stage in person circle hillbilly jamboree. Sorry, only 6 more days to get your tickets to see Elvis Presley. When are like 23 at the time? It's kind of creepy.
That was a kind of testing of his ability to reach audiences beyond his own home in Memphis.
Uh-oh, now they got the shots out there.
Send out road tours to surrounding
and turn around or walk away and then go back or do something with a microphone stand. And he would
on using your resources. Always gotta get the crowd involved, people. Always gotta get your audience involved in whatever you do. Anytime you're performing, you telling a story, you gotta keep them, you know what I'm saying? Gotta catch them slipping. You can't keep doing things the same way. You know what that's called? Insanity.
Brand new artist.
By who?
You finally got a Cadillac.
Hey. Brand new whip, got no keys. Sorry.
Never seen.
Aw. Your first is always special.
It was second hand, but I parked it outside of my hotel. There, I got it. I sat up all night just looking at it. And the next day, well, the thing caught fire and burned up on the road.
Wait, what? Wait, what? His car burned down. He just got it.
It was secondhand, but I parked it outside of my hotel. There, I got it. I sat up all night just looking at it. And the next day, well, the thing caught fire and burned up on the road.
That pissed me off.
I've got a lot of cars, but no one ever takes the place of that first one.
It was the first car you ever bought, and it burned up. That boy was so clean.
The Sun Space was pretty indicative of most small recording studios of the era. You know, they were intimate. They were small. You were up close with everybody and everything.
Okay, this guy on the left, the nigga on the left, right? The nigga, not the one that's not Elvis over there. Yeah, him. He looks like I'll show you the nigga off of the nigga off of Impractical Jokers. Murray. This, oh shit, I mean, this nigga, he looks like him with hair.
When your loving letter told me. Bill Black.
Man, nigga, Elvis is the best dressed nigga in white music history so far. Okay, we'll stop right here. We'll do the next part tomorrow. Savage out. Oh!